Tissue by Imtiaz Darker begins by exploring how paper, initially thin tissue paper, can change things. It can alter things, and as such, it has power. Darker describes the paper in religious books or family histories in which details of a baby's life are written. Paper has power when it is used to divide and to mark out, to segregate, to order, or to control. Darker explores how paper seems to have power in commerce through receipts which control money in finance. But it's all an illusion. It's all like a paper kite. There's no real power, no real control, just the power we let it have. In reality, we give paper power, but it is fragile. And the poem ends with the image of how human life, a different kind of tissue, is similar, powerful but fragile. Now this is just a quick recap of the poem for revision purposes. For more details, see my full analysis video, which I'll link at the end. Imtiaz Darker is a poet, artist and filmmaker, born in 1954 in Pakistan and brought up in Scotland. She describes herself as a Scottish-Pakistani Muslim Calvinist adopted by India and by Wales as well. We'll come back to the importance of this in a moment. Let's think about the title. What is tissue? Well, firstly, it's very thin paper, but it's also the material that we as humans are made up of, human tissue, and both are referred to in this poem. So the two meanings help us bring together the metaphor that human power is fragile like tissue paper. And this is an idea explored throughout the poem, but exemplified very simply in the title, which has a double meaning that draws together the metaphor of human power being fragile. Paper that lets the light shine through, this is what could alter things. What is paper that lets the light shine through? Well, have you ever seen an old Bible? The paper is so thin, it's made up of what's called India paper, very tough, thin, nearly see-through paper. And there seems to be some comment on religious power taking place here, backed up by the reference to the Quran in stanza 2. There's a metaphor that reinforces this too, which is the metaphor of light. Darker describes herself as a Muslim Calvinist, referencing two religions, Islam and Christianity. So how does light play a part in those religions? Well, in the Bible, Jesus says, "I am the light of the world." In the Quran, it says, "Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth." So we can read light here, along with the reference to the Quran and the thin paper, as a comment on the power of religion, with light perhaps being a metaphor for God. And what can the power of God do? It can alter things. It can change things. In other words, God has power. But all the way throughout the poem, light is also used as a metaphor for nature, light, sun, and daylight are some of the examples. So as well as this religious metaphor, light can be interpreted as a symbol for nature. Now in the following stanzas, there are numerous references to things which hold power that are made by humans, buildings, maps, receipts. We as humans give these things power, but the poet is suggesting that they don't really have power. So let's look at them individually. Buildings. Now, buildings are later referred to as capitals and monoliths, which represent human governments and control. They symbolize human power. Next, we have the mention of maps. What do maps do? They segregate. They divide the natural world. How? Through humanity's power. Humans choose how to divide the natural world to control countries, borders, civilizations, and maps are a great example of people trying to exert their power over nature, creating divides which are not naturally there. Then there's the reference to receipts, shown in the quotation, "fine slips from grocery shops." When you buy something, you get a little written or printed statement acknowledging that something's been paid for or that goods have been received. And again, receipts are made by humans. They're used to control through the governance of money, if you like. So the metaphor that receipts can fly our lives and the simile like paper kites suggests that money dominates us, it controls us, it has power over us. So there are a number of references to human power and control through the extended metaphor of paper. As we've already established then, paper is a symbol of human power. Receipts can fly our lives like paper kites, but they are fragile and easily destroyed. Paper kites are easily broken, they're weak. Receipts are made by humans. The suggestion here then is that human power is not permanent. Now the poem is written in free verse, it does not rhyme or have a regular rhythm, there's no consistency of syllables per line, and again these choices reflect the lack of power humans have. As much as people try to order, arrange and control, the structural choices from the poet undermine this and suggest that their efforts are futile. If human power is not permanent, what is? The power of nature. When we read about the paper maps, the sun, a symbol of nature, overpowers the paper, it shines through it. And this symbolism is further explored with the suggestion that daylight breaks through capitals and monoliths. So again, the daylight, being a symbol of nature because it's a natural thing, breaks through the human power. The final line of the poem then reminds us of the title. Structurally, it's a single line stanza, turned into your skin. Well, this is the line where human skin and tissue paper are made to link together. And it takes us back to the point from the title. It's a metaphor which highlights how human power is fragile like tissue paper. If you found this video useful, please do pick up a copy of Mr. Brough's Guide to Power and Conflict Poetry, available exclusively in ebook form and linked in the description. If you like this shorter style of analysis video, do give it a thumbs up and I'll make some more.